It be.
It be us.
It be us.
You know what? We're gonna risk it. I'll try the gem and see what the vendor has.
Okay. Who's voicing the cat? It ain't me.
Oh, I think it should be you.
Okay.
All right, I'll do it.
Yes!
Welcome to my little shop. Buy some shit. I have shit that will boost your stats, shit that will lead you into stupid new adventures, even some shit that might be much needed at some very specific moments. They're called condoms. So take a look. All right, you could buy a corpse. Yeah, I'm selling a corpse. It's like some kind of fashion accessory. It's not as if I'm trying to dispose of it. A fake badass tattoo. It has flames and a skull and even a knife. With this, you can murder your enemies, go to prison, make everyone your bitch, and then murder them too and go to some kind of super prison. Street cred plus 9,000. The gift that keeps on giving. See, I'm wise enough to know when a gift needs given. Yeah. A sexy fake Latin accent. Why? The hardest thing is being yourself, honey, but a Latin accent is a close second, to be honest. A tampon used by the former prom queen. You know, for good old blood rituals, or in case you're just a creep with unhealthy obsessions. Don't even dare ask how I got this. A motivational poster. Crafting your art requires years of hard work, education from great mentors, and tons of raw talent. But damn, that sounds exhausting. So let's settle for a motivational poster for now, okay? A bag of regular cocaine. Good old cocaine. In these times of weird experimental substances and horrible side effects, cocaine has become the new vanilla of drugs. A Russian novel with an insightful approach to universal matters such as love and death. Are you sure about this? You can always use online encyclopedia, TM, to get the general idea and still be able to act as if you've read it. A penguin mask. You want this, you sick pervert? I had no idea you appreciated good old reverse Romanian Wilkinson. I must admit, it's kind of hard that you're into that kick of shit. A blanket with two holes. Literally just a white blanket with two eye holes in it. You'd have to be an idiot to mistake this for a ghost costume, but most of our classmates are indeed idiots. A PR agent. High school social life is so hard nowadays, the hiring a PR agent is totally a thing. And some impractical yet kind of funny glasses. Remember when these used to be cool? No. Now they aren't. But they're so ridiculous that they're still fun in their own twisted way. What are you thinking, Biosh?
Cool. Okay. Which of these will allow me to date the cute eldritch abomination trans girl?
Great question.
I don't know.
Yeah, I mean,
it's probably not blood rituals, is it?
I mean, that is very eldritch abomination, but I'm going to guess that's the vampire.
Or the demon.
It could be the demon.
Or it's, if it's for a ritual, it could be for any of them, if they're doing something evil.
Wait, it's got to be this one, isn't it? A Russian novel with an insightful approach to universal matters such as life and death. She writes fan fiction, right?
Oh, yeah. I'll take the novel.
I might be wrong, but who knows? Bad stranger.
Is your basis on this, like, I both consume fan fiction and Russian novels?
My basis is, right, this is clearly Dostoevsky fan fiction.
Oh, Jesus Christ. I...
The stepbrothers Karamazov.
No.
Over to you, Goggles.
Why did you make me listen to that, Nick?
My brain. You know what? I think I'm going to go to class. We'll see what happens there.
Fucking nerd.
Yeah.
That day you learn a ton of spells that are all as cool as they are seemingly useless. A spell to renew sticker's stickiness. A spell to turn chocolate and vanilla ice cream into vanilla and chocolate ice cream. A spell to gain +2 smarts. You actually use that last spell and you gain +2 smarts.
Fantastic. Hell yeah.
And so, after careful internet research, this plant truly does look good enough to...
What the fuck?
When did the anime guy get here?
Yeah.
I did the shopkeeper, this is one of
mask?
You.
Hello? Marry! That's right, it is I, the interdimensional prince, popping once more into this dimension taken as high schooler for my betrothed. And this time I'm here for...
You start to think of a polite way to explain that you're only interested in one of your 8 most charismatic classmates, or perhaps some bonus newbies, or maybe even people not on anyone else's radar after you've bought an item at the shop or something.
That plant, right there.
My plant, this plant, Plantulina Jolie.
Yes, the very same. She, he, they, however this inanimate vegetable chooses to identify is clearly my soulmate, and marriage to Plantulina is the only thing that will ever save my lonely soul.
Ah, yes, Plantulina. Now I'm playing Laurel Croft.
Calculessa seems a little unsure. Gosh, why is the prince like this? Always crashing high schools to marry people and I guess plant life now. You need to stop him. Wait, do you need to stop him? Shouldn't you just let him marry the plant and stop pursuing your love interests? No, wait, maybe Calculessa would be sad if this plant friend got married. Would he? Gah, I don't know. It'll probably all just be based on your stance anyway.
First answer, you can't marry that plant. It's already married to the sea! Or, yeah, no, wait, no, yeah, just let him marry the fucking plant. I like the idea of telling somebody that a plant's already married to the sea, so I'm doing that. Not so bold. Oh, thank the 9.5 gods! You see, in my dimension, you can only marry vegetation if it's already married to a body of water.
What?
So, Angelina Jolie's marriage to the sea works greatly in my favor. I was willing to break interdimensional law for this union, but this makes things so much easier. Efficient!
A half-plant, half-man emerges from the interdimensional portal with the ungainly movements, achievable only by a half-plant, half-man emerging from an interdimensional portal. He speaks in a strange language, halfway between human speech and the sound of wind rustling through leaves. It's hard to tell when the ceremony is over until...
And that's that. In my dimension, you don't even have to ask the plant's father and or robot holding it for permission to wed. Goodbye, I'm off to consummate this union.
He's off to fuck a plant. Ugh, you shudder to think exactly what such a consummation might entail. But luckily, the prince is gone and you can move on. I didn't even get to say goodbye to Plantulina Joleaf, and now she is gone forever into a different dimension.
Aww.
Emotions found, sadness, loss, betrayal, and remorse. Oh right, it's great that the prince didn't marry Calculessa, but like the hurt in Calculessa's digital eyes. Looks like Calculessa isn't gonna marry you either. Or take you to prom. Fuck. -2 charm and -1 fun it is, I guess.
Ooh.
Wow. Is it time to go outdoors? The library? Auditorium? No, it's time for a shit. That day you skip class and just hang out in the bathrooms because you respect no authority.
Are you just perpetually shitting?
Yes. On the way there, you run into Mamimi the Oni Girl. She offers you some of her weird Japanese energy drink. You take a sip. It tastes crazy as hell. You need to check the contents of this shit. Guarana seed extract, benzoic acid, 50 milligrams of caffeine and 100 milligrams of boldness? Well, it wasn't bad at all. You gain +2 boldness. Thanks, Mamimi, and proceed to the bathroom. In the course of your activities, you come across Vera and Polly hatching yet another scheme. You sneak a little closer so you can eavesdrop. Just casually eavesdropping on two women in the toilets, just as you do.
Listen, this has been a fruitful partnership so far, in terms of making people look like imbeciles.
Hey, to everyone in the chat pointing this out, I would like to remind you all, I'm the Void, and I'm here to void my pals.
No, fuck you, fuck this, fuck off. I fucking hate him.
But I think it's time we monetize sick burns, don't buy fresh outfits. Yeah, yeah, fine, whatever. I guess I could use some new thongs or whatever, but like, I don't want to stop making people look dumb just so we can make money. I don't want to sell out. Personally, I can't wait to sell out. But you have a point. We can't sacrifice our brand. Question, of course, is how do we do both? Yeah, how do we get rich off yanking people's chains?
Wahey.
Nick.
Careful with your choice of words, Polly. You never know which internet personality might be listening. What? Chains are a big thing for ghosts. Of course.
They don't seem to have any immediate ideas. Maybe you can offer a solution. Just lean over the bathroom.
I was going to say, you get, like, spitballing ideas from the shitter.
Why don't you make up a phony workout craze? It worked for Frank Pilates, the inventor of Pilates. Or, man, oh man, do I have a great prank for you. I call it stealing. Oh,
crime,
my
crime.
God.
Nah, the rogue is speaking.
Which crime. One is going to be better for my ghost waifu? I think this one.
I was going to say, it's probably the phony workout craze, because Vera's very into crime.
Yeah. Why do you make up a phony workout craze? It worked for Frank Pilates, the inventor of Pilates.
Now, a fake workout craze. I've thought that right between leg warmers and pages and the things that were a great idea in the 1980s. Sorry, not sorry, but Division Inc. is dedicated to exploring only the most innovative fields of humiliation. Yeah, no force for that fake workout stuff anymore.
No, I failed with both of them.
Because, like, everyone already knows the one foolproof way to get tight thighs and a delicious ass, primping. You've heard of primping, right?
You have never heard of primping. Time to make a swift exit before you look like even more of an idiot. You lose -2 fun and -1 creativity. I'm getting dangerously low on creativity. All right, everybody chooses something bad. Say your choice out loud to the rest of the players before clicking. All right, I've got something.
We're going to have the same thing.
Almost certainly. On three.
Jesus.
No, one, no. Two, three. Elon Musk.
Stories.
Anti-bread. which is Elon Musk.
Well, we can't go for the same thing.
Anti-bread it is.
Anti-bread. Anti-bread Tories and Elon Musk. What's the question? Player orders decided based on how likely it would be for humankind to perish due to the selected thing. I mean,
shit.
Come on.
Anti-bread would lead to mass starvation because it's like negative bread, so it'll take away your calories.
Elon Musk.
You make a fair point.
The Tories
have just destroyed themselves, really. I don't know. I don't think humankind's going to perish. Like, the next general election, they're gone.
Preferably forever.
The economy might perish, but I mean, the rest of humankind will be okay. Elon Musk, though. God fucking damn it, everyone's voted for Bean. Anti-bread is actually doing better than Elon Musk. I figured Elon Musk would get some more votes, or Tories given today, but Elon Musk wins with 16 votes. Bean second with 13. Then second on the poll was Biosh with anti-bread, and then Goggles. All right, who am I going to sit with? Who is this? Is that someone completely new? But do I go over to... I want to know who the new person is. They intrigue me. Yeah, I'm going over there. You're enjoying your meal in peace when you hear the unmistakable sound of free throats clearing. All right, each of us is going to be one of these, right? I'll be the first one in the list on the text. Goggles, you be number two, and Bree could be number three. Does that sound good?
Okay.
Yes, hello.
As you know, it is customary for a benevolent witch coven to have as an ally.
A malevolent creature of some sort.
And since Liam is apparently...
decided he's too cool for us now.
I mean...
because of your incredible...
mate and good looks.
We've decided to accept you.
On a trial basis.
As our supernatural companion for one adventure.
Adventure not to exceed.
3 episodes, or...
eclipse the main plot arc.
We've made such a big mistake.
It's fine.
As a consideration...
for your willing participation...
we'll even allow you your choice of adventures.
3 episodes? You could knock out one of these adventures by the end of lunch, and it actually sounds fun. The Coven gives you 2 options. Stop the crime ghost who's been taking over children's bodies and using them to rob banks. You have a never-before-seen plan. Take on the greatest villain of all, income inequality.
Smashlicism, the capitalism.
I'm not doing this one because I'm 50% sure it's Vera and Polly.
Yeah...
so I'm going to take on the greatest villain of all, income inequality.
I mean, that's definitely Vera.
It turns out income inequality is the name of a giant goblin made of money that's been terrorizing the city. You attack it in the only way you know how, stealing. It's working.
All that money you stole was load-bearing.
Goblin's going to collapse.
Yep, that was totally your plan. You definitely weren't just stealing the money because you wanted money. Excellent.
The day is saved once again.
Thanks to the Coven and our faithful sidekick, the Void.
It turns out the best way to defeat income inequality is by robbing from the rich and giving to yourself. You gain +4 money. Over to Biosh. Well, that was an adventure.
Okay, I picked the middle table. Lowest seat. Do you get to pick a seat?
I don't think you do.
I'll just take the middle table then.
Okay. Looks like Scott and Zoe are having marshmallows for lunch. You say that because their cafeteria table is covered in a literal mountain of marshmallows. Zoe slams a marshmallow into her mouth. It's mildly impressive and deeply erotic. Hang on. Oh, I'm gonna regret this, but here we go.
Ruff, 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 ruff. What the fuck?
Scott stuffed 6 marshmallows into his mouth at once. It's slightly more impressive. I shoved a tissue into my mouth to do that. If a clean one, I need to stress. But now I've just got like dry mouth all over the place. It has absorbed all the moisture that was in my mouth. Zoe begins to glow purple and convulse. Her tentacles swell. You smell death itself.
Ancient chaos, doomed to worlds. Sacrifice, sacrifice, sacrifice.
A cloud of marshmallows rise up into the air, and Zoe's countless mouths all open with an infinite hunger. All of the mallows fly into Zoe's gaping maws. The cafeteria windows open as all marshmallows in a 50-mile radius are summoned to their doom. It is unspeakably impressive.
Hey, no fair.
If I counted correctly, I have now eaten 13,666 marshmallows exactly, which means I win!
Wait, that is like very not cool. You can't use more than one mouth during an eating contest. It's cheating! I would know, because I used my hands as soccer one time and I still feel bad about it.
I've used my back mouth before during an eating contest.
Excuse me, sir?
No way! I didn't cheat. The validity of this impromptu marshmallow match is my whole reason to live. And my whole reason to not destroy this amazing marshmallow filled planet.
Sorry.
Quick, referee this athletic dispute before the whole planet is destroyed.
But it's easy. I'm probably going to side with Zoe, but what have we got? Ugh. We can't control how many mouths we have. That's not nice. Got you a good boy or not?
Love that. Just the way to convince Scott every time is to call him a good boy.
Yeah.
Got play smart and be creative. Don't you have many other holes you could use to...
Ow.
Down.
That's what you tell Scott.
That's what I'm telling you.
Down, boy.
Okay, we're going for option number one. And we're never speaking of two again. Yes.
Scott's eyes widen in primal fear.
Wait, I'm sorry, Zoe. I want to be a good boy. I don't want to be not a good boy.
Wait, Scott, who's a good boy again?
It's me. Scott!
Who was a good boy?
Me!
I'm in hell.
then I guess I'm the winner. My wife's at all.
The bad kind of hell, to clarify.
Not the cool hell. Zoe may have won the marshmallow battle, but you'll win the marshmallow prom date demon friendship war. And that's what really matters.
My god. Alright, I'm going to the nerd and crime ghost table.
Don't you dare steal my crime ghost from me!
Why would I do that? Calculus is right there.
Calculus is cool. But no, not cool. Like, objectively not cool, but like...
And hot. I need my crypto bot. Yes, I am leaning into this bullshit.
You like sitting with Calculester and Polly at lunch because neither of them eat. So you've got plenty of space on the table for all your minifigs.
Hey, I'm a very big nerd, oh god.
Suddenly, Polly grabs Calculus's arm and points excitedly at the vending machine in the corner.
Calculus has got a cool jacket.
It's true.
Calculester, dude, don't look now, but that vending machine's totally checking you out.
Impossible. Vendronica and I have a purely platonic relationship.
No way, dude. Take a look at her insides. No drink, dude. She's thirsty.
It's gone. It's veered straight into dial 10 again.
Hey, it really has.
For drinks?
Shiny mess last.
Current status, highly uncomfortable with this topic of conversation.
This sounds like just the kind of thing that's none of your business. Time to interfere.
Yeah. Oh my god, okay.
Polly could probably help the machine get a vending... the vending machine get a makeover. You know, find a lipstick that would really help her pop.
Wow, Polly. So just because the vending machine is a machine, you assume she has feelings for another machine? That's pretty racist. Or, but Calculista, have you actually told Vendronica that you only want to be friends, or is it time for a DTR?
What's the DTR? Do the robot? No.
I don't know.
Dial town.
Dial town rando.
Oh, Christ. Can you? Oh, you can, I can imagine. Down to rummage. I like that. Down to rumpus.
Down to rampage.
Oh, wow. We don't want to get the robots down to rampage.
Oh, no, I'm down for that. I'm sure it'll go fine.
Dirt free rally. God damn it. Oh, anyway. Define the relationship. Oh, you're right.
Okay.
I do prefer dirt free rally, though. I did not know that you were a mechanicist, friend Polly. This is disappointing. Did you know that Vendronica's last partner was a slippery elm tree? Before that, she dated a bottle of cream soda. These stereotypes are harmful to all robo-kind, Polly. And you are not being very robo-kind.
Oh my god.
Do you know what's really bad? That's just entered my head. The idea that Vendronica probably said to the bottle of cream soda, cream inside me.
No. Their relationship was definitely quite vanilla.
Fucking.
Oh, yes.
Damn it, Bree.
Oh, fantastic.
What? No, but some of my best friends are robots. One of my best friends is a robot. One of my best friends is a robot, please.
Calculester allows Polly to remain friends with him, for now, but only because he likes friendship, on the condition that she checks her worldviews a bit. He seems to like you more based on your robo-sensibility.
Yeah.
Let's trade places.
Is this an 80s dance craze because you're going to do the robots?
Oh, I like that.
That's a good one.
All right, everyone choose an animal. I've got one.
I've got one.
Yep.
All right, 3, 2, 1, seagull. Alright, I don't know why I keep getting us to do it all at the same time. That's just really foolish. What was yours, Bree?
Drill.
And Goggle?
Tapir.
Tapir, nice. Player orders decided based on how strongly you would avoid eating the selected animal. So I went with seagull. Biosh, you went for?
Drill.
Squirrel. Goggles, you went for?
Tapir.
Tapir. All right. Okay. Right. Okay. I think these are all pretty difficult to choose from. We're definitely going to need a poll.
Yeah.
No, seagulls in last place because they deserve it.
you would eat a seagull because it deserves it.
I think you would struggle because seagulls are such dominant bastards.
Exactly. I need to assert dominance.
Seagulls come with a free side of chips.
Look. If you capture one seagull, eat it in front of the rest. The rest of them are going nowhere near your fish and chips.
I'm trying to think, would I eat a squirrel? And I think the answer is yes.
Have you seen that video of a guy who grabbed a seagull? Like, I think he grabbed it, like, from his chips. He's kind of holding it, like, right around, probably where the shoulder is. And it's just bizarre. You just see this guy holding a seagull and these other ones just kind of circling around him moderately ominously. It's just like, Jesus Christ.
Oh, Christ. Would I eat a tapir? I think almost certainly. Like, I don't think...
anyone who tried to eat a tapir, they're adorable.
Yeah, but so are cows. Cows are adorable. Like, they're big cuddle monsters that are so fluffy and they just love cuddles and nose scratches. But I still eat one.
Yes, but they're very tasty. Have you ever tried tapir? Yeah.
So you have eaten a tapir.
Maybe.
I don't know where to go from there.
I'm trying to think, what's the cutest animal I've eaten?
Lambs?
Lamb. Lambs are cute, yeah. Cows are cute, lambs are cute. Chickens, no. Fish, no.
Chickens are cute. You ever seen a large fluffy chicken that you can just hold? They're adorable.
Chickens are fucking weird dinosaurs.
Yeah. What's the weirdest animal I've eaten? Kangaroo?
No, kangaroos look like horrible little men.
Yeah. Just weird little guys. Yeah, I think that might be the cutest thing I've ever eaten. I'm sure I'll remember some obscure meat that I've eaten in like a Brazilian steakhouse somewhere or something. I'll be like, oh yeah, totally. Oh, I've had venison. Deer are cute. This is a weird segue. Anyway.
It is. I'm just like, I can't contribute.
The two winners are Seagull and Bean. So the Void wins. But Be Oshaw Goggles, Seagull, Squirrel, Tapir. So Squirrel second, and then Tapir.